a good time. I mean, you're not here for this math stuff. You're here for memes.
All right.
Okay, physics does not work like this. This is the part I've...
I mean, are we concerned at all about salmonella? I mean, this is raw fish.
That is some nasty raw fish.
I see the red. I see the red.
Yeah,
yeah, buddy.
Okay.
Keep going, zombies. Keep going.
Should I watch this or study for step?
This one was written at 12 a.m. No family history of undeath. We started IV fluids just because. Plausible deniability.
You, get out of here. Yeah, go study. Yeah,
you're right. Rated M for med. You're right about that.
Okay, welcome. We are doing a zombie-themed stream today because everybody who is a second year is studying for Step 1, aka the exam that must not be named.
Does that mean they're dead?
Somebody should probably check on them in their apartments. I mean, I mean, if you notice somebody who has not been outside in a while or their Amazon packages are accumulating outside, just check on them, maybe?
I did hear a lot of people crying the word brains, but maybe they're studying for neuro. That's what I was assuming.
I hope that's what it means. All right, so what we're doing now, before we begin anything, we're going to be playing Overcooked 2. But before we do that, a research project showing if you use statistical modeling to see how the zombie virus would spread across the United States. So what we are going to do is we're going to bring up from this model called Zombie Town USA, we are going to drop a zombie into California, and then we will periodically check back to see how that is spreading.
Why California? Where in Cali you want to drop this thing? In a very populated area, San Francisco?
Yeah, let's go for it.
All right.
LA? Okay, we're dropping it in LA. The red represents the parts that are zombies now. And we will check back periodically to see how that's spreading. So hopefully we will make it to the end of the stream without it reaching us here. But, you know, be on the edge of your seats.
So we're playing some Overcooked, so...
Overcooked 2, specifically.
My apologies, Overcooked 2. So later on we'll play Overcooked 1, maybe another week or so, because I have so many Attack on Titan memes to make.
I know, right? That opening scene is really great.
Some octopus thing.
It's the Cthulhu chef.
The bald eagle from the United States. I don't know why Uncle Sam is here. Just throw him to me.
Doritos coming at you.
Thank you, man. This stream is sponsored by Doritos.
Saw my life flash before my eyes, and it ended in Doritos.
I mean, considering any MLG person knows that Doritos and Mountain Dew are part of your diet when you're playing video games. I'm sure everyone outside can say so. People, nod your heads. The only problem is we don't have any Mountain Dew today, but at least we do have Doritos.
We Mountain Dew not. Oh my god, that's terrible. I hate myself now. Okay, let's move on to the game. Oh, by the way, we will have questions later on, so we're gonna have renal questions, we have a zombie question, and we have another science in the seance. It's the science or medicine behind the original zombie myth, so that will be later on.
So the following is based on actual events. Wait, did this actually happen in real life?
What's your favorite vegetable, or least disliked vegetable?
Let me see. I don't know, I don't really have a unliked vegetable. I kinda like all vegetables except Corella. That stuff is nasty.
We have an equal opportunity disliking of vegetables.
That thing's bitter, man. What are you talking about?
Ooh, what is this?
That makes sense now.
Oh my god.
Wait, how does everyone understand what the dog is saying?
You know, Carl, we're playing a game about an onion king and zombie bread. I mean, I wouldn't really question the logic of the universe that we're playing in here.
That this guy who's like the onion king guy, he's just like, whoop.
Yeah, this is exactly what it looks like when I try to cook something in my kitchen.
Wait, exactly like this? So wait, do you have to fight zombie toast when you have to make breakfast every day?
Oh, yeah, my toast is definitely rising from the dead.
How burnt is it when it comes out, when it rises from the toaster?
My fire alarm has gone off multiple times. My toast had a past medical history of burntness. The unbread?
The unbread? Wait, are there actually dead pieces of toast? What is this? There's a baguette? Why? This is madness.
Alright guys, call out what you need, and then we'll plate it. We'll put it down here, so we'll prioritize those.
Oy vey, why people?
Did you just say oy vey? I mean, I approve, but okay. Oy gevolt! Is this the level where you can't win?
I think it's the level- Okay, why are you guys losing to zombie bread? The unbred. Why? That's what I want to know right now. Man, you guys are so bad you can't even beat zombie bread.
Jesus. We're so bad, we don't even know how bad we are.
You're almost as bad as burnt toast.
Nothing is as bad as burnt toast.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. The horde is too ravenous. Wait. I just heard someone say crouton. So if we dehydrate the bread, do we get crouton zombies?
I almost did a spit take with Pepsi. Thank you very much for that. Fried all this fancy streaming tech here. That would have been very tragic.
That would have been very tragic, oh Miss Technomancer.
I don't believe in our electronics. I have a bad habit. Do you know I got stuck in an elevator earlier this week for 30 minutes? Yeah.
So are you sure?
And it was the second time that happened. So I broke his iPad once by touching it. I have a bad track record with technology.
Here, it's still broken to this day.
No, seriously, it was working fine, and I touched it, and it...
Hold on here, touch it again.
Is it still working?
No, I think it just froze.
I don't... Get out of here.
The technomancer.
I believe in you people.
Okay, we also need someone to wash dishes.
Wait, you need people to wash dishes?
No, we just need to have roles so that we're organized.
And one of those roles is that someone needs to wash dishes.
Oh, I see how it is. Oh, whoops. I just dropped that on the floor. Is that sanitary now?
5 second rule?
There's no 5 second rule. They disproved it.
Wait, what kind of bacteria get on your food if you drop the food on the floor?
I mean, we're dropping a lot of food on the floor here. I'm really concerned. Yeah, the sanitation department's gonna shut us down.
Actually, I think the health review is knocking on our door. I think he just gave us an F plus.
An F plus?
Wait, which is more depressing, an F plus or an F minus?
Do you think anyone's ever actually gotten an F minus?
They don't give pluses or minuses for Fs.
Okay,
they just give you an F.
Also, I mean, are we concerned at all about salmonella? I mean, this is raw fish, and we're just dropping it all over the place.
Okay, don't worry about it.
That is some nasty raw fish, I'm just saying.
Yeah, you're right. I shouldn't question the logic in a zombie toast thing. Who's throwing fish? Someone's just throwing fish! How do you like it? You know, my character's kind of like a squid. I mean, are there some issues with me cooking fish? What do we need?
Did you guys just lose?
Oh. I feel like I contributed nothing to that effort.
You're done? All right, pass me that.
Okay, we have our first casualty of the stream. Do you want to
continue where you left off?
Do you want to say bye?
Oh, to the stream?
Yeah, say bye. This is our spinning dude from last time. Obi, he was spinning in a chair. Say.
Yeah,
remember you were spinning?
The dramatic spinning.
Keep spinning around, sir.
Hi.
Oh my.
Oh yeah. Hello, stream. I hope everyone enjoys the Overcooked, and watch out for zombie bread. Just don't eat it. It's just not tasty.
Yeah, there's mold on that. And there's like pseudo hyphae and stuff on that. That's nasty.
After this, do you guys want to check on our zombie simulator thing?
I
see how that's doing?
To see what's happening to LA.
Yeah, I'm wondering what's happening to LA too.
Get over here, vet. We're good, man. How's life?
Overcooked.
It's Overcooked.
We're fighting the good fight against the unbred.
Oh, shoot. That needs a plate. I was about to serve dirty food on some sort of non-plate.
Yeah, we're getting shut down by the health department. Hardcore.
This is bad teamwork at its finest.
Yeah.
Zero communication. What are we doing?
All right, shrimp next. Shrimp is next. I'll call out the order so we know that we're in the...
Oh, they have to go in order?
Yes, it's the one all the way at the left is the upcoming order. Okay, now you can do that one. And shrimp is next. Good. All right, we need a shrimp next.
Just getting plates,
get
people.
Ready. All right. All right, we need fish now. We already have a bunch of extra fish, and time is up.
Darn.
Nice.
Da 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 da.
We're just checking on the progress of our zombie. What happened?
It's working.
Why isn't it red? It should be red.
It's red here.
It should be spreading a lot faster than that.
But remember, this is the whole Midwest.
Oh, maybe that wasn't a good place to drop it.
Since California was the worst place to put it, I'm putting it in New York. Sorry, people. Have fun.
Okay, guys, we kind of messed up. Apparently, the entire Midwest front was blocking our zombie attack. So apparently, California is the best place to have a zombie outbreak begin. Who knew? So that little region there is where we have our zombie outbreak. So we'll check back on that.
So speaking of which, maybe we should have a question. Also, for the guys who are in the place that must not be named and you're watching, you do realize we still have pizza, right?
Yeah, we have a lot of pizza. Yes, it's right over there. We have pizza.
And the best part is that no one's here to eat it.
Okay, also, Obi, shout out to Obi, the spinning dude you may know him as. He brought cookies. If you bring cookies, you'll be our BFS for life.
Yeah. Or for as long as we know you, I think.
Yeah, as long as we kind of know you. And Mountain Dew. But Obi's awesome. He brought us cookies.
And Mountain Dew. You know, I'm going to leave this stream now because this is a stupid joke.
We just want to let you know that you're in for a good time.
See?
Okay, there he goes. That's one way to get Carl to leave. He's just getting pizza. He's not actually gone. Yeah, he's just kind of driving this around. I don't know what he's doing. Are you having fun? I mean, at least we don't mind if you're having fun. If you're happy, we're happy. Let's go back to learning. So you're in for a good time. We're still not sorry. I mean, Carl, sorry. I'm not sorry about this okay. Bad pun here.
So it says drug X is given orally and metabolized only by the liver. A patient is taking drug X. After 4 doses, she has achieved a steady state serum concentration of 10 milligrams per deciliter. The concentration of X in the hepatic artery entering the liver is 10 milligrams per deciliter. And the concentration in the hepatic vein leaving the liver is 5 milligrams per deciliter. Liver plasma flow is 500 milliliters per minute. So what is the clearance of X?
Wow, they're taking it seriously.
Why are you people actually calculating this?
You want to introduce yourself? Cam's on you. James is taking this question completely seriously. We set him up for a bad joke about just calculating it online, and he is doing the math, so round of applause for this guy. Gotta do the fake guitar. Your eyes.
So I'm gonna finally put this to rest so we can move on with our lives.
Are you guys on this seriously? Fine.
Whoa, whoa. Okay, wow.
You're the one in charge?
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, here's what we have. The clearance is the removal rate over the steady state concentration. So the removal rate in this case is gonna be the 10 minus 5, because as we know, we're losing 5 milligrams per deciliter, times the 500 milliliters per minute, since that's the liver plasma flow. I'm also going to do some quick conversion, so 1 deciliter is equal to 100 milliliters, and I get 25 mgs per minute. So whoever said 25 was amazing. So the clearance now is going to be 25 over 10 times 100 milliliters per minute, and that gives us 250 milliliters per minute as our clearance in the liver. So take your drugs. Wow, no.
What?
I was about to say take your liver
back
drugs,
up,
but no.
Little.
Yeah, never mind.
The meme. Oh. Yeah. I mean, you're not here for this math stuff. You're here for memes.
Right? All right.
See, not sure if my back hurts right now or my... No, is my back hurting right now? Hey, can you do... No, let me see if I can do my own costa vertebral angle.
Wait, do you want me to see if you have CVA tenderness?
No, I'm going to do it myself. Ow, 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 ow. Oh, God. That hurt. Ow. Oh, God.
That was delayed. You're faking. You obviously have Munchausen's. Okay, guys, I don't even know why we need the levels. This is fun in and of itself.
You know, don't play game where I'm just driving around.
You're just driving the bus. That's all you're literally doing.
Oh, wait. He has to get his pizza. No, he has to get his drink. No, he has to drink his drink.
Swallowed too much pizza, man.
You swallowed pizza.
He's ready, man. Here you go.
It's not about shooting the pizza. It's about swallowing the pizza.
It's not about shooting the pizza. You hear this, man?
Carl, you made a huge mistake putting me on, but thank you.
We have our like CSA clinical skills assessment thing, and I actually ended up talking about Game of Thrones with one of my standardized patients. Yeah, it was very random, but you know.
That's how we do. That's how we
also,
do.
Like if you just go to hospital to learn to work together, we would be as colleagues later.
Yeah, that just entirely based on how we play Overcooked too. That is everything. We need a system. Who's on chopping? Who's on like plating serving?
I'm on chopping. Yeah, buddy.
I'll put the rice in the pot.
Where's the rice?
Oh, I got it. Wait, where'd my rice go? Oh, I dropped my rice on the floor. No one saw that.
Well, the sanitation department is not going to be happy with us, no matter how this goes. Why is everything about fish? I don't know if I would have chosen a squid character if I knew everything was going to be about fish.
I don't know. There's too many people crowding.
I don't know what's going on right now.
It's okay.
Someone please cut some fish.
I have cut fish over here, but I can't add it to the pot. Oh, there's no fish in it.
Listen, I got you. Fish on the plate.
Okay,
oh,
fish on the plate. Where's the rice? I got the rice. I don't want to burn you. There we go.
I don't care if you burn me. It's okay, Carl.
Wait, what?
Someone's gonna put the rice down. Rice it up. Let's rice it up. Yeah, buddy.
Guys, we have life. like five orders piling up. All right. If I'm understanding this correctly, they designate which one needs to be cooked. So only the rice needs to be cooked. The seaweed and the fish can be raw. So how about we put a bunch of plates here, put raw seaweed and the chopped fish on a plate here, and then someone would be in charge of the rice. We just put it on the seaweed that will be waiting here. So put the raw, just load the raw ingredients. Okay, so just load the raw ingredients on plates right near where they're going to be served, and then cook the rice over here and bring it over there so that we don't have everything just mixing together. Wait, we got it. We should all have different roles, ideally, so that it's less complicated. Here, let's just need fish right near where... Quickly, we're running out of time. Put a fish right next to where we're serving. See, it has two ingredients, and then serve. Good, okay. So now we have two more plates set up. This fish is not chopped. Somebody grab this fish. Don't... Yeah, we have a bunch of cooked rice.
At least we didn't fail anything. Hold up.
Wow. Our new standard, not failing. Okay, how's the rice doing? That's about to burn. Somebody grab that. Okay. This one's ready to go. Serve that. Alright, we need one fish here.
Hey, fish, there's another plate over.
Alright, serve that.
Got it.
Okay, we need new plates. Okay, there's one thing that just needs fish. Somebody caught one fish and this is ready to go. Put it on here, that's ready to go.
Alright, come on.
I got it, don't worry about it. I got it.
And serve. Okay, we need one more fish, quick. We only have time for one more thing, and serve it. Everyone get out of the way, okay.
I think we did. We got it. Okay. We got the three stars.
So, do you guys want to check on the zombie apocalypse and then maybe play something else? Yeah.
What is going on with the tri-state area? There's too many people here.
Wait, how do we know where the zombies are?
So everything that's red is a zombie.
Yeah, it's kind of. You see how it's spreading down there? See, it's like spreading. So we have the eastern seaboard over here, and okay, if you are in Maine right now, just wait. Just I'm really sorry. You might want to get you might want to get on a boat or something.
Look at that. There's still people chilling there.
You have like an Oklahoma group going to like New York, Texas, California,
and Seattle.
See, yeah, that's the thing about this. Like, we should be seeing things lighting up already in other places just because of the travel on different planes.
We need to play Plague Inc. That's how we really know.
Oh, right, Maine has been swallowed up. So here, if you bring up the controls, this is the variable that you can adjust that represents the kill-to-bite ratio. It might be spreading really slowly right now because we have it set to 0.8. If we made it different than it. Yeah, like 0.3? We can adjust it. So I'm lowering it to 0.3, so we'll probably see it spreading faster. Also, our zombies take 11 minutes to run a mile. That is our other variable. Exactly. Like, these are Walking Dead zombies. Let's have some World War Z zombies. Now we're,
I see the red.
Faster.
I see the red.
Yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
Okay.
Keep going, zombies. Keep going. Hit up Michigan. And they can just run forever. They're like perpetual motion machines.
Yeah,
just keep
on
going.
Okay, well.
All right, now we're actually moving. So you can see how changing that has now adjusted our time frame.
Whoa, what happened to all
the kill-to-bite ratio? It was too high, so people weren't actually turning into zombies, which is why it was spreading so slowly. They're running faster, they are turning more people into zombies. Can we take like a 5-minute break?
Yeah, so hit the beat.
Just take one step at a time. Just one step at a time.
Word power and take it page by page. Just one step at a time. It may take a little bit longer, but the way one step at a time, boy. Just one step at a time. You gotta plant your feet on solid ground. You can't climb a tree and then chop it down. You gotta start from scratch, work your way on up. Every land once was above. Just one step at a time, boy. Just one step at a time. Word by word and take it page by page. Just one step at a time.
Okay, we're back from our break. Towards the end, we're going to do our zombie question and some facts about the science. I wrote a question. We're also going to go over, like, the scientific basis of the zombie myth.
Do that again, sir.
I'm just gonna put it on you. Squat down. Thank you.
All right. And
we're
back.
I forgot my headset.
You have your headset on.
My bad. Okay.
Okay, so when you were complimenting me, you had your headset off. Okay, so we're changing over to Smash, obviously. Let's check on our fast zombie apocalypse now.
Oh, right, the zombie apocalypse.
Thank you.
Michigan now.
Whoa.
It's hitting the Midwest. Oh, geez, I'm scared.
Okay, all right.
But you know that means New York is dead, so aren't we all zombies right now?
I was a zombie from the beginning of this stream, so I don't really notice a difference.
So wait, are we immune to zombification? All right,
fine, we'll play.
Damn,
okay,
dude.
Okay, disgruntled. Can I call you Morgan Freeman, because you refuse to be anywhere where the camera can catch you, but... Yeah.
You tell Adam to come down right now and we'll put him on stream.
Yeah.
We will put on Adam if you tell him to come on stream. We are serious, all right?
If he's willing to fight the zombie apocalypse.
Honestly,
to get here.
Get Mike too while you're at it.
All right. All right, enough of this chit chat. Let's play.
All right, fine. Let's play.
Jesus.
Die. Whoa! You guys hurt a lot. Ow, Lucina. Stop. Wait, you still have 3 lives. I don't like this, Sam. Oh, come on, people. I was gonna kill her. Oh.
Excuse me.
Yeah. Okay, honestly, I saw that kill. That kill was sick. I'm sorry to say. Hold on. There we go. Much better. Ow, Kadar. There we go. By the way, guys, we're out of pizza because you guys weren't here. So we now have all your pizza. And they ate the rest of the pizza.
Yeah, they were hungry for pizza.
Oh. Oh. Ow. Die. Oh, that didn't kill. Oh! There's what? Salt? Oh. Why is that insulting? Oh. Wow. I was even noticing that.
I did not.
Darn. Darn it, Sam.
The mic hunter.
The what?
The mic hunter?
The mic hunter?
Wait, like, as in she's actually on the mic, or she just killed Mike? I don't know which one. Oh my gosh. I love that the only person we can't see is Kadar, because Kadar is just like
he's the narrator.
Freeman. That's what he is.
He's Morgan Freeman, the disembodied voice that is on the stream. Oh, what player is every... Someone wants to know what player is which. Okay. Kadar is Kirby. Carl is Take Notes, who also Incineroar. Jack. AKA
Wait, how do you know about Gen 7?
Jack, aka Joker, is Mike, and I am playing as QED, aka Lucina.
Speaking of which, how does everyone feel about the new Pokemon series?
You want to talk about that creepy Sonic movie that you?
Oh yeah, you're right. The creepy Sonic movie. Can we talk about the creepy Sonic movie?
You know, I think that this was their plan all along. They knew that there would be trouble with showing a live-action Sonic, so they showed something really terrifying that they were never planning to use before actually showing us the real model, so people would be more accepting of it.
Yo! Okay. Boom! Bye! You know what? I'm just gonna grab somebody now.
Oh no!
And that's you.
The one time I counter, you always grab out of the counter.
Ah!
Wait, I'm still alive?
Oh, now you're not. Okay, you're still alive. Oh, people! Okay, you killed her for me. Okay, thanks. Joker! How'd that miss? No! Wrong way! Dead. Everyone's just catching these hands today, okay? You know, like that's how we play. Oh, come on, I wanted that.
Okay.
That would have been good. Ow, I have a shield, broken shield. Don't hit me. Thank you. Okay, you hit me, thanks. How did that miss? Dead? No, not dead.
Not
dead. Ow, that hurts. People! Kadar, aka mostly Kadar.
Oh no!
Ow, that hurt. I thought I had armor on that. I'm just gonna get these. Oh, I wanted that! I wanted that so bad. No, you don't do two frames. Oh! Oh, I wanted that.
You can't always get what you want.
Oh!
Wait, Sam died first? Yeah. How did that happen? Oh,
give me that! Wait! No!
You might find you get what you need.
Kadar just killed all of us. Welcome back, Steven. You just missed it. We're all in the Shadow Realm except you. You have to save us all. Someone save that. Yeah.
Okay, guys, I just want to let you know there are some people in the chat. One person doesn't like Twitch chat at all. Well, that's an ironic choice then.
We need more banter. Should I watch this or study for step?
You know, I already told the story about how I got stuck in an elevator this week. I mean, I don't know what you want from me.
Now, what are you doing?
Yes. I mean, I got stuck in two different elevators, one in 35 and one in 45. Like, two different elevators, 20, 30 minutes. I mean, it was not fun. Yeah, but basically, it got stuck on the first floor and the door just wouldn't open. And this is the ground floor, and the floor of the elevator was here. So it's like that scene from Final Destination, except thankfully nobody actually, you know, got cut in half.
But we have to go 27 flights of stairs. He had to go to
you must be in great shape then.
Wow.
If you have to go up 27 flights of stairs all the time.
She just burns everybody, bro.
I think she's really angry that she didn't win this match.
That's why.
I congratulate you on your win. It was a well-played match.
Was it? Was it a well-played match?
Wait, by the way, how's the zombie apocalypse going?
Oh, right, the zombie apocalypse. How could I forget about the zombie apocalypse?
Okay, see,
you know, it's kind of hard to forget about a zombie apocalypse when it's happening. It's pretty noticeable.
Okay, I feel bad for Florida. Florida's gonna die soon.
I mean, who cares about Florida?
Because all the people who are retired to Florida, it's the only place that you're gonna get infected.
Yeah, but California's still alive. I don't like this.
You don't go to Cali. Who realize that? You guys picked the worst location to start a virus.
Well, okay.
New Yorkers never leave if they do it at retirement age when they go to Florida.
Wow, that's
it.
Oh my.
You've limited your options.
He actually has a point, though. Wait. People want a live bet on this match?
Okay.
How about this? You guys get a scholarship if Kadar wins again. How's that sound?
Shit.
And I mean, we reimburse all of Kadar's tuition. I would bet on Gandalf.
That's a good choice.
You should bring FIFA. Y'all people, okay?
If you guys have suggestions for things, we will...
We'll take any
maybe
and
take
all...
Them under consideration.
Wait, would you be stuck matching into your least favorite specialty or contract one disease randomly selected from Pathoma? Yeah. Okay, what do
random
you guys think?
Disease
random disease from Pathoma. Okay, we got random disease for Pathoma. Y'all people, like, my God. Pathoma hands down. I would agree, people. Like, Pathoma hands down. And as you guys can see, now you have the ability to kind of see your chats on stream, which is great.
Sure, but do we want to switch to big screens so they can actually see what's going on?
Oh, right. We need to switch to the big
screen. Oh, no! Can we start over? I just jumped off the edge because I was looking at the chat. Fine. What is...
How'd you die?
I was looking at the screen and I walked off the edge.
Who has their money on Sam?
Excuse me.
She can't win. What's going on?
I'll just have to play it safe.
You don't. You never play it safe.
You
get real.
If anyone else, you would have been like, sure, yeah, we're gonna start. So you actually yeah. Locked off an edge, but because
nobody
it's me.
Has a chance.
Oh no, I didn't kill anyone with that. I feel so bad. Alright, Kadar, die.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you're supposed to die, Kadar, not hit me. Jesus, man. Ugh, everyone, get off of me. And then someone like grabbed me. No, you didn't, dude.
Ah! There's two stars. Holy.
Ah. Alright, so we have Glove Steve. I need to switch these names. God have mercy. Y'all people. So we have Glove Steve versus Jacoza.
So, what do you guys want to talk about?
Like, seriously, what do you guys want to talk about?
We're gonna just watch this match in complete silence. I think that's the best thing to do. It's really interesting to do. I see. So...
Complete and utter silence. Like all you hear is the clicking of the controllers.
Just, yeah, clicking.
But speaking of which, let me see what I remember about this matchup, actually. So, like, Lucina has to kind of get in. That's the only problem. But she doesn't have to worry about spacing because, like, she doesn't have, like, the whole damage is better on the tip of her sword. So it's pretty easy for her to, like, just quickly get in and, like, do stuff. However, Young Link's projectile game is amazing.
Yeah, you need a little context there. So, Marth, his attacks are his strongest at the very edge of the sword. But
yeah.
Lucina's moves, she plays very similar to Marth, but the damage is more evenly distributed, so if you hit somebody anywhere with it...
Actually, because of that, she doesn't really play like Marth at all, because Marth has to space, because Marth needs
yeah.
his tip to kill.
Exactly.
But, like, Lucina, she can just go in and, like, just do stuff. So, it may take her longer to kill... Like, Marth might kill earlier, but, like, Lucina
yeah.
can still get, like, good stuff.
I also find she's slightly faster.
I think that's also a little bit true. She might be a little bit faster.
That's
supposedly
one of the reasons I... That's why I think...
She feels a little bit more fluid to play, though.
Yeah, I find her very fluid as you know, character.
But Young Link now has, like, the best projectile game out of the three Links, so... And dead. Okay. I think Michael's about to JV3 this, or 2-stock this. I don't even know anymore. What were you saying?
It probably wasn't important.
Yes, it was. Everything we say is important here.
Well, if it's important, I'll remember.
Fine.
Come on, we gotta talk about something interesting. I mean, did anybody do anything all week besides study and go to rotation? Yeah, that is...
So wait, I heard that scientists finally programmed the first black hole, but it looks like an orange toilet bowl cleaner.
yeah, I saw everybody was making memes about that before. I was too busy to figure out what it was about, but that was it.
Like, did it really take us years to take a toilet bowl and, like, turn it orange? Like, seriously? Like, even Smash understands a black hole better than these scientists.
Yeah, let's talk about some science stuff. I mean, what's going on right now?
Oh, speaking of which, I was actually reading this yesterday. There's a physicist at MIT, like in March 2018, he actually discovered like a new superconductor for carbon.
That's cool, but what implications does that have?
Well, it's an organic conductor, so maybe one nanobots could be real later. Who knows?
Oh, cool. Do you think one day there will be nanobots that kind of mimic the action of our antibodies, except kind of... change on the fly to you know, like viruses.
I wouldn't be surprised.
You know viruses that mutate really quickly so our immune system can't keep up with it, so they
basically
be like the immune system, except they would change immediately in response to whatever they encounter. Have you ever heard of the singularity?
Yeah.
Like the technological singularity.
How long did that take you to do, Mike?
I don't know if you you watch The Good Doctor, but they always have those really fancy scenes where they're using some virtual reality thing to...
Oh, that's going to be fun.
They basically scan the patient's anatomy, so they kind of practice doing the surgery before the surgery. And I'm wondering how close we are to that actually being a thing that can be useful.
Honestly, who knows? But I think we're actually going to get some good music here. Let me turn up the music.
Okay, I'm not talking. I'm concentrating. I don't know any of the Joker moves.
Turn up that music.
What was that?
You guys ruined it by playing on Battlefield. You've been playing on the regular stage. It's legal.
This is tough. I have no idea what any of his moves are.
So Joker has a gun, which is kind of surprising. The gun doesn't do any damage. Like, it does damage, but it doesn't do any knockback, so you don't have to worry about, like, dying from it. Except maybe now, but yeah. And as Joker takes damage, he gets to his persona. So when he's at his persona stage, like, yeah, pretty much, because you could die. He also has a counter and a reflector. Pretty much. He's very fluid, but if he doesn't have persona, he can't kill. And I think Mike would tell you that. Wait, Mike, how long have you been playing Joker? How the heck? Okay, fine. Smash artist, like, as in drawing Smash or actually playing the game? Well, as of now, I think he's about to beat Sam, only because Sam doesn't know who Joker is.
Yeah, I don't know any of his moves. I can't really...
Okay. That thing that he shoots at you does damage over time. So it zombifies you. Yeah, that thing. That thing zombifies you.
What is... I don't... Yeah.
No, so what happens... You see how your damage is going up randomly? That thing ends up, like, causing your damage to go up randomly.
Oh, it's like DPS.
Yeah, DPS. So don't get hit by that, but it goes in that trajectory.
You know, I'm really glad you told me that, because I'm just running right into it. You know, that missable.
Yeah, don't be countering too much against Joker then. Also, from what I'm noticing, he's not using Rebel's Guard too much, so I guess you could go on the attack.
Dutch.
Rebel's Guard is the down B counter move that Joker has that lets him build up his persona meter. He takes a little less damage, but... Like, he gets to get his persona out. Mm-hmm. Oh! This was close to dead. This is the part I would tell Mike that he has F to use it. Oh, I forgot to change this. Oops. Sorry, people. Let me put PD on here. Alright, there we go. Much better. Yeah, Joker's dash attack's amazing. That's also amazing. His F tilt's amazing. I'm saying his F tilt's amazing and I don't see an F tilt. Like, this is sucky, but okay. Also, he has a back air, which is also amazing. Just saying. Up air is a kill move. Ooh, look at that F tilt. Wow. I said up air was a kill move. I said up air was a kill move. Oh my god. Okay, who's next?
I will take you on.
And Kirby?
Oh god.
Is this like the winner moves on?
Winner moves on, so after you, then Christian, then me, I guess. That was clutch.
Yeah, I don't...
Okay, who's fighting against who?
I changed it's not actually says QED. I don't know if it said QED before.
Alright, who's... Wow. Alright, I got you. Done.
You have those movies where someone's really good at reading moves and predicting things, so you just throw someone at them that has no strategy at all and they win?
Oh, yeah. Alright, hold on. Carry on.
Yeah, he's literally
What?
I have no idea.
You bastard. Where's the comet camp?
I gotta go.
All right, man. I'll see ya.
See ya.
Yeah, thanks for stopping by, man. Yeah, there we go. Oh, wait. Did she win? Oh, no, she didn't. Okay, fine.
See ya. Thanks for stopping all right. by. It's not.
It's technically rated M for mature. Like, we're all med students here. Like, I think we are allowed to be mature. You're right. Rated M for med. You're right about that. And yeah, guys. So like,
yeah,
I guess I'll make a pro to that. But we do now have a YouTube channel. We'll be posting it sooner or later. That yeah, we have a YouTube channel where we can post some highlights and stuff.
Yeah, like we'll edit out all the boring parts.
Yeah, all the boring parts.
And by we, I mean me, because I'm doing it. With all of my myriad free time, I enjoy editing, you know? It's time consuming to do a good job.
As much as you enjoy being a content creator?
What? Not a content creator?
Yeah, like with the amount of content you create on the stream, you're a content creator.
I don't know, I'm shooting anything, but...
Yes, you are. Like, you make the slides, like, you help set up.
I write weird questions at 11 p.m. and do research on...
Amazing weird questions. That's the issue.
I mean, I appreciate that.
But...
Just having fun with it.
Well, isn't that the point? We should always have fun with the stuff we do. By the way, people, yeah, as we said, you missed all the pizza because y'all people are frauds. Like, we told you guys to come in. You know, we said we have pizza. I even posted that we have pizza, and like, now all the pizza's gone. We legit had to have more than one slice of pizza.
But you can still learn about the origins of the zombie myth and its basis in actual science and fact later.
I actually really want to see that now.
I did a lot of research.
How much research did you? Okay.
It was interesting.
Dead.
This is taking too long.
No, she's like, this is taking too long. She just went and killed him, like, for free.
I told you it
wouldn't go back. I won. Good game.
Yeah, but how much research?
You know, I'm a lifelong learner, so I actually enjoy looking things up. Oh, by the way, someone asked if you should be studying for step one or watching this. I mean...
You should be doing both.
Yeah, I mean, ideally, you could be learning stuff, too.
I mean, we talked about creatinine clearance, which is on step one, so come on, people, like... We did go there.
Yeah.
And we're about to go there with a zombie question later.
So anything weird happened to you guys this week? Anything fun, interesting? That interesting, huh?
All right. Define weird, Kadar.
Yeah,
let me hear this.
Define this.
Yeah, I think some of those weird things you need to keep to yourself. What are you talking about?
Oh, cool. You bake bread? What kind of bread? Oh, cool.
Fraud.
Well, it might be moldy by now if you did.
Hey, wait, is it zombie bread? What do you mean not yet? How long have you left it out? wait, let me hear this. It's been out for how long? Let me hear this. He's actually thinking.
Can you freeze them?
So that means they're on their way to turning to zombie bread. What do you mean he has no time? He's a first year. He has time. What are you talking about? Fine. Fine. But yo, when you're free, you better come back here, man.
Don't worry, bro.
Okay, perfect. For that part. mm-hmm. Okay, fine. It should be, like, okay. Pretty much. Oh, we'll see about that.
Oodles and oodles of fun to look forward to. There
okay. are While you do that,
memory.
I don't
know.
What?
You got no sympathy from me.
We should take an intermission to do the zombie question after this. We can talk about the zombie ideology, check on our apocalypse, and then I have a nifty survival guide.
Why do you have a survival guide? I think you might need to load up on chainsaws.
You know, actually, I think, I forgot who it was, Mythbusters or something. If you have a flamethrower, then a zombie will keep walking towards you, but they'll just be on fire now, so I think that makes your situation worse.
Alright, fine. I nearly had that too. So mad. Die! Oh, you're dead. I like it. I like it.
That would have saved me though. I was actually trying to get hit by that.
Ow, that hurt.
Because then I would have had an extra recovery. One of the good things about editing the footage is that I see all the mistakes I make from previous matches, like I didn't grab enough.
Why do you care about the mistakes that you make in matches? Like, you want to be a...
Just a curiosity, because I had to be editing it. So I noticed I was not grabbing enough, and I missed a lot of good opportunities. No, I just was observing.
Nah, she wants to go pro in this game. What are you talking about? Ooh. Again.
See, the thing is, he knows I like to counter, so he'll grab me out of that. So I can't believe that.
Ah! Got him? Ow, that hurt. Ooh. Been wanting that. Oh. Oh. All right, there we go. Oh my God, I'm losing. Well, not
really.
I'm afraid! Oh, that's gonna kill. Okay, fine. I'm good. I'm good. Hold on, I'm on it. No, you didn't! Okay, hold on. Wait, wait! Ah! Yes! If it doesn't work the first time, do it again!
Alright, good. Yeah, good match. Good match.
I think I have a decent win record against Sam now.
If it was you versus me, I'd be betting my life savings on you. But like,
yeah.
You know, so like.
Hey. Put on the question. I give up.
All right. Good match though. That was fun.
That was fun. That was fun.
Jonathan Colton makes the most amazing songs. He has an entire song just about DNA. We are beginning to break into the Midwest. Guys, I have a question for you. If you were studying for step one, you had your test date all picked out, and you have to get to the testing center, but you've now discovered that a zombie apocalypse has broken out. Would you still risk life and undeath to get there?
No.
Oh, wow. The tip of Florida is really holding out there. What's going on there?
Well, remember, everyone's in Miami. The zombies are in Disney World right now. They're good. See, Orlando's gone already. We'll go
to the question. I think I wrote this one at 12 a.m. They're getting later. I think the last one I wrote was at 11 p.m. and this one was written at 12 a.m. Rick is a 25-year-old medical student with past medical history of self-diagnosed chronic fatigue syndrome and insomnia. I don't know if you're watching, Sebastian, but we have improved on our previous question set where we forgot to put an age and a past medical history. At the time of presentation, he was seen shambling across the campus courtyard with a broad-based gait, slouched over, and drooling.
He sounds like a second-year medical student.
All right, witnesses reported seeing him wearing disheveled, tattered clothing, but just assumed it was because of final exams. Collateral information. A concerned neighbor reports that while trapped in the one barely functioning student apartment elevator with him the day before, she noted he was complaining about being hungry before breaking into incoherent ramblings about Final Destination and Tower of Terror.
Random question, was that you?
I'm going to say plausible deniability. Review of systems positive for travel history. He returned from an exchange elective in Japan 2 days ago. One known exposure to a squirrel bite a month ago. No family history of undeath. A fellow student attempted to get close enough to take vitals, but then realized they forgot their stethoscope at home and didn't really feel motivated to run upstairs and get it. They did note a respiratory rate of 5, but weren't really sure, so they recommended someone else double-check that. The student then proceeded to ask if he had a recent corneal transplant or any strange raw meats lately, but the patient was non-responsive except for some incoherent mumbling. In the morning, the second student reports to his attending that Rick clearly has A. rabies, B. prion disease, C. cerebellar degeneration, D. really bad jet lag, E. tetrodotoxin toxicity, F. a lesion in the ventromedial hypothalamus, G. too much free time and should be studying for step one instead of shambling about the courtyard, or H. no acute events overnight with stable vitals, and then he leaves to attend a vague mandatory conference.
I like the part where it says he needs to go study for step. That kind of sounds right.
I see. Rabies? You're going with rabies?
Morgan
Freeman's
going
with rabies.
Tetrodotoxin toxicity.
Tetrodotoxin, why?
I don't know, it sounds right.
Sounds right?
Yeah.
Sounds right. That's the kind of evidence-based learning that I like to put behind things. We started IV fluids just because. Before I show the answer, I just want to give everybody an opportunity to say what they think the answer is. If anybody is remaining. If the zombies,
we do have 3 people on.
If the zombies have not gotten you yet from our apocalypse. All right, it is tetrodotoxin toxicity.
Guessing works.
Yeah.
But explain it to me, because I haven't seen this in a while.
Sure. So tetrodotoxin is the correct answer, and there could actually be more than one correct answer, because I don't work for UWorld, but you know, this was the most correct answer choice. So he got a squirrel bite. That is a risk, because rabies symptoms can take weeks or even years to present, because the virus can lay dormant. A corneal transplant can lead to prion disease, but he did not have one. He has no history or evidence to suggest a cerebellar etiology. As we know, the cerebellum is responsible for balance and gait. He recently traveled to Japan. So in Japan, there is a delicacy called fugu.
Fugu.
Yes, fugu is made from pufferfish. Actually, people go to school for years to learn how to properly prepare this dish because it takes only 0.2 milligrams for tetrodotoxin to be lethal. Pufferfish themselves do not produce tetrodotoxin. They are not inherently poisonous, but there's a symbiotic bacteria that actually causes it, and they kind of use this as a defense mechanism in addition to puffing up and having all those spikes on them. A lot of the symptoms arise from its ability to block sodium channels, so it leads to paralysis of many muscles, including the diaphragm. It's what actually ends up being lethal, the respiratory distress and arrest. But the first symptom that you get and the first sign of toxicity is a tingling sensation in the mouth. That is actually said to be desirable to certain consumers of fugu, and it's a sign of it being prepared expertly. It is also believed by many to be one of the key toxins implicated in the origin of the zombie myth. Also, just for fun, the CDC created a zombie preparedness website. No, you can actually check it out. Here is a poster you can see on the right. Get a kit, make a plan, be prepared. And they have a whole bunch of information in there. Leading into this, the science in the seance. We show the science in different myths.
Look at this.
Plausible deniability. A lot of the modern day zombies, as we understand them, originated from Night of the Living Dead by George Romero. This was the prototypical modern day zombie as we know them. The shambling, hungry, undead humans. Modern day, we have walkers from The Walking Dead. We have White Walkers from Game of Thrones. No spoilers, don't worry. But the whole thing actually started a lot earlier. But before we talk about tetrodotoxin and where it actually came from, we discussed rabies, which can cause aggression, muscle paralysis. It can, interestingly enough, it causes a fear of water. So you've noticed in a lot of movies that zombies refuse to cross water. That can come from there. It paralyzes muscles, you can get drooling, you can get mental confusion, and eventually death. Prion disease gets into the brain. It can lead to muscle stiffness, changes in gait, difficulty speaking, and other brain pathology, and they progress quite quickly. Lesions to the cerebellum cause the shuffling broad-based gait, the way that we classically describe it in medicine, but that is also very similar to what we see in zombies. And then also a lesion to the ventromedial hypothalamus can result in increased appetite. It's a satiety center in the brain, so it basically tells you that you're full. So if you knock this out, you constantly have, they call it hyperphagia. You just keep eating, which is what we see zombies do most of the time. Now we're getting into the original zombie. Then a lot of this is speculative. The sources are not exactly the best, but, you know, it's just fun to think about. The zombie myth is said to have originated in Haiti. There's a bokor, which is kind of sorcerer, that would use a combination of ingredients that was called zombie powder on the supposed target. Certain anthropological accounts determine one of the ingredients was tetrodotoxin, and theoretically, sublethal doses kind of give the person the appearance of being dead by depressing the respiratory rate, and they didn't really have the best clinical exams, as we've discussed back then. Yep, just like that. Okay, we get the point. And this may have been alluded to in Romeo and Juliet, and then the effects would wear off later, so they might potentially be buried, and then wake up later, come back, say, honey, I'm home, and then everybody would think they're a zombie. Then it was also speculated that the Bokor would use a plant called Datura, which is known by many names, including Jimson Weed, which you may have heard about in class, Devil's Snare, which you may have heard about in Harry Potter, and randomly Devil's Cucumber. And it's an anticholinergic, so it can lead to symptoms of delirium, muscle stiffness, confusion, amnesia, and sometimes aggression, all things we see in zombies. Also, interestingly enough, Wikipedia has this guy who is cited as the first zombie. It says he's known for allegedly being a zombie.
What the heck? How can someone be known for allegedly
I don't know, but the story goes that he was thought to have died, his family buried him, and then he showed up 18 years later and was identified by a relative who said that was indeed him. And that is the origin of zombies. And also, just as an aside, because I mentioned that I don't think zombie movies are really effectively preparing you for the apocalypse, this is a brief guide to surviving Z-Day.
Alright, let's see this.
Number one, just call them zombies. We all know what they are. Also, you're not the protagonist from Die Hard. So just use stealth, hide in your apartment, live off canned soup, and wait for the natural elements to wear down most of the zombies. Toilet paper, save it up. It's gonna be like gold in the apocalypse. And also, forget about the safe haven. So everyone's gonna be talking about this place. That's the perfect place. Everyone's heading there. Everyone's heading there. Don't go there. Probably already overrun by zombies. Let's skip the first half of the movie. Just go to an island.
Can we just go to the Midwest United States? Nobody lives there.
The thing is now, everybody knows you're supposed to go to the Midwest. They've run the simulations and everybody knows this. So that is the last place that you want to be. Just go to an island and you'll be safe. And if you can't get to an island, go to Costco.
Why Costco?
Okay, Costco. Hear me out. It has bottled water, canned food, can openers, it has mattresses, there's endless exploration and adventure, you get some free samples if you get there fast enough, and they have those steel metal things that they pull down at the end of the day,
Yeah. So
it has everything that you need.
But don't you have to be a member of Costco?
I think they'll make an exception in the event of a zombie apocalypse. Can you imagine that? Like, it's a zombie apocalypse, and you go to Costco, and you're being attacked by the masses of zombies, and there's just some person waiting at the front, and they're like, are you a Costco member? Oh, I'm sorry. You're just gonna have to do your best out there. Okay, guys, so get your Costco cards now, so you are set. Isn't that what we already do at med school? We just have a bunker with lots of toilet paper and canned food, and we don't leave for days on end.
Anyway, guys, so... since we're gonna wind down a little bit,
yeah,
we're gonna play some Mario Kart.
Yeah, we're just gonna play some Mario Kart.
I'm not playing Mario Kart because I wanna build a bike. I'm playing Mario Kart because, you know, I wanna drift and throw blue shells at people.
What are you guys gonna play?
Rainbow Road.
Rainbow, oh god, no, people, why? Fine. Oh, this is gonna be bad.
Also, the CPUs are really good in this. Do you think that CPUs are basically the video game version of a zombie? Because they basically just, you know, sort of mindlessly stay on their track and follow their programming.
It's perfect sense, honestly. Okay, who is in front of me? And if your name is Sam, you're going down.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Where are you, Toadette?
Maybe.
Okay.
Oh no, who's putting bananas down? There's always that one person who puts bananas like right in front of the item boxes, that
maybe
sharp
a
turns.
Triple.
Just places they know people are going to hit into.
Oh wait, who's gonna hit me? Ow. Damn it. And wait, how did Sam get past the blue shell?
I'm playing Mario Kart because, you know, I want to drift and throw blue shells at people. I don't know. I'm in first, so I have no idea.
Who hit me again, you frauds?
Well, maybe I was in second or something, and then it hit the person who was in first.
Now I'm in fourth. This is stupid. Not to, like, actually work.
Oh, great. I just saw a green shell sail past me. That means somebody is right behind me.
Wait, the blue shell hits people? That is so weird.
It's okay. I have a coin. It'll protect me.
No, it won't.
Darn it. Wasn't there, like, some Edgar Allan Poe story about a pendulum thing?
That's a very good question.
I'm pretty sure there was.
Skill. Oh, I'm in seventh place. I'm just doing so many.
I've gotten hit by like three blue shells. Okay, two. One, but one was very aggressive.
Sixth place.
I always like watching the replays on this because you get to see all the ways that people really messed with you over the course of the match so you can be appropriately mad at them.
What's going to happen when one day, like, both Sam and I are out of commission?
Out of commission? What happens to us? Yeah, I don't know how our zombie apocalypse is brewing.
Well, we'll figure it out later. It's still on. Okay, physics does not work like this. People don't steal. Oh. I nearly.
Oh, I just threw a banana at someone and it hit. That was really weird. Projectile motion!
Projectile motion? This doesn't make any sense. Like, how do you steal people's energy by bashing into them? Ow! Okay, fine.
Yeah, it kind of makes sense, right? Like, physics. Didn't you ever do those physics things where one ball hits into the other ball and
oh
then
yeah, equal momentum, ow.
It transfers energy to it.
How do I keep not making that?
Carl, are you, the shy guy?
Nope, I'm not the shy guy. I'm
Who's
Black
shy guy?
Yoshi.
Who's shy guy? You?
He is. He's like...
Glove Steve. I'm gonna call you Glove Steve. I know your name is actually just Steve, but now I've said Glove Steve too many times, so. Wait, you're not wearing your gloves today!
Who keeps hitting me? Okay, fourth place.
Oh no!
Well, who is stealing? Okay, your VAT weight. Oh, I passed it! Yes, finally. For once in my life. Okay, that's how you do that. Okay, now I know better. See ya, people. Third place. No! Ah, Kadar second place. Sam is still first place. Wow, did they really just call me Black Yoshi?
Oh no!
Oh no!
Did they legit just call me Black Yoshi?
Oh no!
Let's not dwell on this for too long.
Darn it! No! See, I need the terminal montage. I need to find the terminal montage video now. You know what? I'm gonna play as White Yoshi next. I need to see if they call me White Yoshi.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! Hey. They did it, man! I'm shocked! For the Yoshi, they pride themselves in the fact that the Yoshi are different colors. Ow, who hit me again?
Did you just get hit by a green shell?
No, I think I got hit by a red. I don't even know.
Did anybody just get hit? Oh! Well, I was not expecting that.
Then again, it is true that Mario Kart destroys relationships.
No! Okay, who just hit me with two red shells? Oh,
oh
no!
Skill! Oh my gosh.
Oh no.
Skill! Skill!
Alright, well played.
Yeah.
Something else is too.
This is good. I don't like breaking ground. Breaking Bad now is amazing. You know it's true.
Why my controller's like going to the right?
I think it's because
it's stuck.
How'd you stick your own controller?
No, it's just like drifting to the right. Got stuck on it. Well, that's unfortunate.
Oh, about to say. Wait, I was going the wrong way all this time.
Well, my controller decided.
Let me see.
To, I'm still playing. Yeah, it just it stopped doing it. But
hold
it was
on,
just,
let me see.
It was driving like there was a cliff, and it was just drifting.
It's probably the stage.
It took a bunch of time to.
Wow, my God. You know, it would be so bad if I was in 12th place. So there's a tournament montage where we had all the different color Yoshis.
I could probably edit that in.
Well, I don't think you want to edit the part that I'm thinking of in, okay?
I don't know what you're referencing, so I can't, okay. I cannot determine if
when
it's
you,
a good
when
taste.
When you watch it, just look for the part that says, I didn't do nothing. You'll see what I mean.
Maybe I should look this up.
No, you should look it up. You'll just never put it on stream. That's the point. I mean, we are rated M, so.
Rated M for med student.
And hey, I'm sure that when tests come around, med students will swear up a storm. See ya, Toadette, aka Sam.
I'll be back.
Yeah, you said monkeys. Perfect.
I said I'll be back, except in a Terminator voice.
Okay, even better. Why is it that I feel like I was just on LSD in this place? Oh my God. Then again, it's Rainbow Road. Rainbow Road looks like a giant hallucination to begin with.
You guys are, like, if anybody's interested in watching this after, I'm just warning you up front, you're not going to see this thing for like 3 months.
And hey, that's actually medically relevant. One of the things about LSD is that it causes hallucinations. It's true that Mario Kart destroys relationships.
I'm playing Mario Kart because, you know, I want to drift and throw blue shells at people. Watching the replays on this because you get to see all the ways that people really messed with you so you can be appropriately mad at them.
Mario Kart.
Editing is fun. You just have so many possibilities.
I'm going to make a joke on this and I'm not going to.
Staff credits. Oh, because we were playing on Rainbow Road. Oh no! No, anything but the credits.
All right, peeps. I think this is a good time to end this great stream.
We want to see how our zombie apocalypse is doing.
The Midwest is still saving it.
So our plan is see where patient zero is from and then make your plans based on that.
But look, Miami still hasn't been hit yet.
Oh, wow.
Neither has Key West. Neither has the Everglades. Oh, wait. No. It's gone. Wait. It's going. It's going. It's gone. Fine. It's over.
All right, guys.
Miami's dead. It's over. We lost it. He fought well.
All right,
get on.
We hope that you learned something about zombies or Mario Kart, or I don't even know what we were talking about half the time. But, yeah. Yeah, you should probably go study for step one now. It's probably better use of your time.
See, we don't have to study because we're done with it already. Well, except you. You, get out of here. Yeah, go study.
Yeah, go study.
Get out.
Go
get out. Actually, wait. You have to study step two. Get out of here, too.
That's true.
I'm leaving. All right. Take care.
Wait, you're just leaving me on stream with these people? That's the joke.
Okay, fine. Bye.
Take care, people, and thanks for watching.
Rated M for med student.